Hey everybody, how's it going? Those of you who have been following the channel for some time now know that along with my regular videos, I always try to find something a little bit different and a little bit unique to bring to the channel. Today is one of those vehicles, a custom 2002 Ford Excursion with the optional 7.3-liter turbo diesel V8. And this is going to be a full, in-depth tour of the Excursion. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clipping over the performance data, and show you a bunch of the unique features of the interior as well as exterior. I'd like to give a big thanks and special shout out to Brandon Reeves Auto World, located in Monroe, North Carolina, for allowing me to come out and film this very unique Ford Excursion Turbo Diesel. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start her up, let her run. The exterior is a two-tone silver and dark gray, featuring a light flint cloth interior. And when the Excursion first came out for the first few years, it was available only in XLT and Limited. This is the XLT trim, which is the quote-unquote base model. It came pretty well equipped, with standard cloth seats, and Limited was definitely the more posh trim. Go ahead and hoist ourselves up. And it has just over 122,000 miles. Beautiful sound. Simple power rack and pinion steering, and a full leather-wrapped steering wheel is standard. As far as the transmission, standard in these earlier models was a 4-speed automatic, but when the 6-liter power stroke came out in 2004, a 5-speed automatic replaced this transmission. It also has electronic overdrive. This particular vehicle, since it has some modifications on it, was actually fitted with an upgraded BTS automatic transmission. And so we're going to flip on the automatic headlamps, as well as the hazards. Side windows automatic down. And we're going to check out the exterior, shall we? The Ford Excursion is definitely a really neat vehicle. Originally produced from 2000 to 2005, it was Ford's largest SUV offering ever. It was also built to take on just about any job on the sturdy, heavy-duty F-250 truck platform. With a variety of engine choices, you can take your pick basically depending on your different needs. A standard 5.4-liter V8, a 6.8-liter V10, and this particular vehicle's 7.3-liter turbo diesel V8.
Properly equipped, the vehicle can also tow upwards of 11,000 pounds.
Set of chrome clad aluminum alloy wheels with high-profile off-road tires. Paired with four-wheel disc brakes. Another thing the Excursion holds is a record for being the heaviest and longest American SUV ever produced.
It's 18 feet 10.7 inches long with a curb weight of around 7,197 pounds. While people don't buy an Excursion for gas mileage, on the highway it can get upwards of the high teens, but most likely on average it'll be low teens with a 44-gallon fuel tank on diesel fuel.
The interior is a basic no-frills interior that is basically built for function versus luxury. Like I mentioned earlier, the best word to describe this is pretty utilitarian. We have some swords with cloth accenting located on the bottom of the door panels with a bit of illumination, two-tone accenting, all of your power window switches, power locks, and power mirrors. Pretty much the entire interior is lifted from the F-Series heavy-duty pickup trucks. Reasonable comfort. The seats are power sliding, tilting, with manual lumbar and manual recline. And a little bit of bolstering for some better lateral grip. Textured running board. Manual tilting steering wheel. As well as an aftermarket gauge set for some of the vehicle diagnostics. See she sounds. Gotta love the sound of that turbo. Standard equipment was an AM/FM radio with in-dash single-disc CD player and a tape deck. You have various storage compartments and sunglass containers, opening up the rear vents on either side of the vehicle, rear air conditioning controls, as well as a little digital driver information system that shows your fuel data, outside temperature, and compass. 12-volt power outlet, two cup holders, another power outlet down below, and various means of storage, your four-wheel drive controls, parking sensors, and rear defrost. Your simple climate control is here, your different zones and front defrost, temperature and fan speed. The radio is also really simple. All of your presets change between AM, FM, seek, tune, select, going between your different equalizer settings, and going between your tape. Pretty simple. Cruise control mounted on the steering wheel, intermittent wipers and controls for the rear wiper, display brightness, and a variety of comprehensive gauges for your fuel, oil, transmission, and vehicle temperature. The auxiliary gauges up here are also followed suit for other vehicle diagnostics, including the boost pressure, but that's aftermarket. Two cup holders built into the center console, integrated clipboard, and a lot of storage space down below. Not to mention armrests for the front seats. Alright, gotta shut her down. And we'll check out the back seat. As you would expect, the back seat is enormous.
Total seating is for 9 passengers properly equipped.
In order to fold the seat down, first you gotta pull up on that strap there, then press this lever and flip it back. All you have to do is then flip this over to bridge the gap. Then press this lever, slide it all the way up to allow easier entry and exit for the rear passengers. Rear audio controls and a power outlet.
Rear AC controls, plentiful amounts of vents, rear illumination, plenty of handles, coat hooks, and an aftermarket rear entertainment system.
Backseat room in the rear is also very plentiful. These things are to flip down when you fold the seats all the way down to bridge that gap in the floor that would be. And you'll also notice the seat belts in the back are also adjustable just as the front are.
And we're going to check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we?
Spare tire would go over there. The factory spare tire, that is.
Same power and manual adjustments found in the passenger seat that you see on the drivers.
A good size glove box. Definitely an SUV of epic proportions, able to take just about any cargo that you want to haul or tow anything that you want to tow. Can be either loaded up, optioned out with your variety of engine choices, or you name it. Pretty customizable and definitely unique. Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this detailed look at the 2002 Ford Excursion Diesel. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.